Good morning, children. Yesterday we have discussed about electric field intensity, and electric dipole. More than that, we have defined two terms, that is axial line and as well as equatorial line. Today we are going to discuss about an electric field on an axial line due to electric dipole. So for that purpose, I am going to take an electric dipole. So what we are going to find out now is electric field on axial line due to electric dipole. So I am going to take one dipole here. The dipole midpoint is O. And the distance between the dipole, that means two poles, is going to be 2A. And this is the axial line. The line which is passing through the two charges is called axial line. So on this axial line, I am going to choose a point P. And my intention is to determine the electric field at point P, which is on axial line. That is nothing but axial field I want to find at point P. So, how I am going to know the electric field at point P? The first step is, I want to find out electric field at point P due to minus Q charge. And after that, electric field due to point P due to plus Q charge. So, with the help of these two charges, I can able to find out electric field at point P, and after that, if I am going to take the resultant of these two fields, so then I will get the net electric field at point P. So that is nothing but axial field or electric field on axial line due to dipole. So let us go with the step-by-step process here. Before going to that, we have to understand some distances. So as this is 2A, and now from dipole, our midpoint, point P is at a distance R. Now the distance between A and as well as P, that means minus Q and P, is R plus A, and Q and as well as P. So here this is at B, point B, and BP will be R minus A. So now first of all, let us calculate the electric field due to minus Q at point P. So here, electric field due to minus Q at point P is given by is EA, well, because the minus Q is existing at point A. EA equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by distance, square of the distance between A and P, which is nothing but R plus A. This is R plus A whole square. This is equation 1. If you want to write in terms of vector, so this is EA bar. So here is an interesting point. Let us take that particular point here. What is the direction of EA? EA is going to produce by minus Q charge. So then in this case, if you want to calculate EA, EA will be towards minus Q. So this is EA. I am going to represent with this vector. EA will be towards. Why? Because always electric field will be towards minus Q. Okay. So as it is going to be opposite to the direction of here R bar, so I am going to write it as minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R plus A whole square. Still, this minus sign indicates that this is going to be in the opposite direction. That means opposite to the R bar. So if you are going to write this is the distance R bar here, So we can write it as minus. And next coming to electric field due to plus Q charge. Electric field due to plus Q at point P is EB, which will be equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by the distance between B and as well as P is nothing but R minus A. This is R minus A. So I am going to write it as R minus A whole square, and this is equation 2. And now what is the direction of EB? As we are going to write it as EB bar, the direction will be here, it will be away from plus Q. So this is EB. I am going to write EB. This is EA is minus and EB is plus. Why? Because EA will be in this direction and EB will be in that is away from plus Q. So now if you want to find out the net charge, the net electric field at point P, so this is nothing but the vector sum of EA bar and as well as EB bar. So these are bars here, we can write it as bars. So the net electric field, so the net field on point P is given by E equals to, or E net must be equals to EA bar plus EB bar. So we can calculate this one very easily. So this is only magnitude, we can calculate that one according to the steps here. E net equals to EA plus EB. Okay, with the previous slide, we can write EA bar equals to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R plus A whole square. This is the first equation we have written. And EB bar equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R minus A whole square. Okay, this is the second equation. And now the net electric field at point P is given by EA bar and EA bar plus EB bar. So EA bar plus EB bar or EB bar plus EA bar, no problem with that. This is the resultant vector sum of these two. Why? Because they are going to exist on same line. So this is EA and this will be EB. Sorry, in the previous diagram we have written as EA and as well as EB like this. So then EB bar and this will be EA bar, as they are going to exist on same line, we can add them up directly. So then in this case, directly 1 by 4 epsilon naught Q by R minus A whole square minus, why? Because EA is going to have minus N in opposite direction. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R plus A whole square. And now while taking the common factor, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught as common, 1 by, we left with 1 by R minus A whole square minus 1 by R plus A whole square. And here, taking the LCM, you will get R plus A whole square minus R minus A whole square divided by R minus A whole square into R plus A whole square. This is simple LCM. And while expanding these terms, you will get R square plus A square plus 2AR. And here this will be R square plus A square minus 2AR. While multiplying with minus n, you will get minus n minus R square minus A square plus 2AR. So the signs will be getting changed. So in the denominator, you have R minus A whole square. I am going to write it as R minus A into R minus A. Okay. And this is R plus A into R plus A. And now let's go with the cancellations here. R square and as well as R square will get cancelled. And here A square and as well as A square will get cancelled. And you left with 2AR and as well as 2AR. Totally it will become 4AR. So here Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, this is 4AR divided by, look at this here carefully, R square R minus A into R plus A. This is R square minus A square. a square. So this is r square minus a square. Why? Because a plus b into a minus b. And next one is again it will become r minus a into r plus a, again r square minus a square. Okay. So totally you will get, I am going to rearrange this equation q by 4 pi epsilon naught. I am going to write as 2a into 2r divided by, look at this, r square minus a square, r square minus a square whole square. And now here what is q into 2a? Q into 2a is nothing but, actually we have discussed about electric dipole moment. So that electric dipole moment will be q into 2a. We can write it as electric dipole moment. So then we can write it as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q into 2a is nothing but p into, again we are going to left with 2r divided by r square minus a square whole square. So this is E axial, we can write it as E axial, we can write it as E axial, or otherwise E net, or you can, here also you can write it as E axial. Okay, so be careful of with this particular derivation and cancellations. Okay, rearrange them properly to get out with P. P means here electric dipole moment. Okay, E axial equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P into 2R divided by R square minus A square. Okay, where P is nothing but here electric dipole moment, and if you want to write it in terms of vector, we can put bar here and here also we can have. And P bar, E bar will be in the direction of P bar. Okay, so then this is the finalized equation for E axial. And now there is an approximation in this particular equation, we have to go with that. While taking a dipole, dipole is going to be very small, it is not going to be lengthy, and it is quite small. So then if you are going to consider point P, let us take, if this is going to be dipole here, this is minus q and this is plus q, and which is at point B. This distance is already, you know that this is 2a, and if this point is going to be, the point P is going to be too far from the dipole, this is something like r. So r is far rather than a, so that is the approximation we are going to do here. If r is far greater than a, what will happen to this equation? So if r is far greater than a, so then you can neglect this particular a here. So what happens to E axial? E axial is approximately equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p into a p bar into 2r divided by, when you are going to neglect a square, we left with here we are going to have square also. So then here if you are going to neglect a square, so then you left with r square whole to the power of, again we are going to have square. So r square whole square is nothing but r to the power of 4. So in this case we are going to take the cancellation. So you left with this is r and this goes by 3. Okay, 1r will be gone here, it will go. So here E axial must be equals to, E axial must be equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p r, otherwise I am going to write it as 2p divided by r cube. So you can write p bar also. This is going to be the formula for E axial. So most of the cases we are going to make use of this formula, and we are making use to solve the problems. Okay, so be careful about this particular formula here. Why? Because E axial is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2p by r cube. Okay, noted.